Are you ready to knock out? Pathways of the sympathetic nervous system. Let's start with some basics. The sympathetic nervous system is also known as the fight or flight system because it's activated when the body is in a state of stress. Physiological changes that occur as a result of this system mainly include things such as elevating heart rate, increasing breathing, sweating like a pig, and decreasing digestion. Anatomically, this system is composed of a two-neuronal pathway. The first neuron, or preganglionic neuron, originates in the lateral horns of the spinal cord. The second, or post-ganglionic neuron, originates in one of two places, either the paravertebral ganglia, which lies on either side of the vertebral column and is part of the sympathetic chain, or the prevertebral ganglia, which lies in front of the vertebral column. Well, actually it lies in front of the aorta, but the aorta lies in front of the vertebral column, so it's close enough. Impulses that synapse within the paravertebral ganglia follow either the spinal nerve pathway or the postganglionic sympathetic nerve pathway. The spinal nerve pathway takes impulses to the body wall to innervate smooth muscle within things such as arterioles, sweat glands, and even erector pili muscles. The postganglionic sympathetic nerve pathway takes the impulse to viscera within the head and neck, as well as within the thorax, including the heart and lungs. Now let's consider synapses that take place in the prevertebral ganglia. These signals take a splanchnic nerve pathway, and their postganglionic fibers are destined for viscera within the abdomen and pelvis. It's worth noting that there is a third location in which preganglionic sympathetic axons can synapse, and that is within the adrenal medulla. In this pathway, there is no postganglionic sympathetic fibers. Rather, the synapse occurs within the adrenal medulla itself, which then works to release the hormones epinephrine and norepinephrine, which enter into the bloodstream to prolong the effects of the fight or flight system. Are you ready to learn the pathways aerobic style? Let's do it. The nerve cell bodies for all of the sympathetic pathways originate in the lateral horns of the T1 to L2 spinal cords. Let's demonstrate with a little arm movement. Be sure to join in and say it with me. T1, L2, T1, L2, T1, L2. Axons are going to exit the spinal cord, like any respectable motor fiber, via the anterior or ventral roots. We'll add a little hook kick to note the trajectory of these axons. The anterior root looks like a hook, right? Well, maybe kind of. Anyway, make sure you're saying it with me. Anterior root. Anterior root. Anterior root. The anterior root joins with the posterior or dorsal root to form a spinal nerve, which shoots out horizontally just like a sidekick. You know your job. Spinal nerve. Spinal nerve. Spinal nerve. Following the spinal nerve, the signal must jump onto the highway known as the sympathetic chain. It does so using an on-ramp known as the white rami communicante. So let's jump on board. White rami communicante. White rami communicante. The sympathetic chain
is a long nervous structure that runs along both sides of the entire vertebral column. So stand up tall and straight to properly represent. Once in the sympathetic chain, some major decisions need to be made.
To synapse or not to synapse? That is the question.
Let's first choose not to synapse. This means that we are following the splanchnic nerve pathway to abdominal and pelvic viscera. Exit the sympathetic chain via splanchnic nerve and synapse on a pre-aortic ganglion. Splanchnic nerves generally descend to reach their desired ganglia, hence the reason we are dipping down to follow the trajectory of those nerves. Splanchnic nerve, synapse. Splanchnic nerve, synapse. Splanchnic nerve, synapse.
Side note.
The nerve cell bodies of the postganglionic neurons may be located in either the celiac, aortico-renal, superior mesenteric, or inferior mesenteric ganglia, which all fall under the umbrella of pre-aortic ganglia. The axons of the postganglionic fibers find the nearest artery to hitch a ride with and then follow that vessel to its final destination. Waddle on to your final destination.
And that's it for the splanchnic nerve pathway, carrying sympathetic innervation to the abdominal and pelvic viscera.
The adrenal medulla pathway is exactly the same. However, the preganglionic fibers just pass through the prevertebral ganglion on their way to the adrenal gland, but do not synapse there.
Let's take a step back and consider option number two when in the sympathetic chain. To synapse or not to synapse? That is the question.
This time, let's synapse. Now that we are in the sympathetic chain, the signal may ascend, descend, or stay at the same level before synapsing in a paravertebral ganglion at the spinal level it will exit. Ascend, descend, stay the same, synapse. Ascend, descend, stay the same, synapse. Ascend, descend, stay the same, synapse. The postganglionic fibers then hop onto a gray rami communicante to make their way to a primary rami. Hop away, gray rami communicante, gray rami communicante. If going to the skin on the back, the signal will travel on a dorsal primary rami, whereas if it's going to the skin anywhere else in the body, it will travel along a ventral primary rami. Now you know the spinal nerve pathway.
But what if the signal's going to the heart and lungs?
Back in the sympathetic chain, some of the signal will ascend to synapse on a paravertebral ganglion in the neck region. But instead of the axon exiting via a rami communicante, it leaves via a postganglionic sympathetic nerve, such as the cardiac nerve, and travels directly to the effector organ.
That's it for the four pathways. Should we review? Probably so.
Splanchnic nerve pathway to the organs of the abdomen and pelvis. T1, L2, anterior root, spinal nerve, white rami communicante, sympathetic chain, splanchnic nerve, synapse, postganglionic nerve to viscera of the abdomen and pelvis, adrenal medulla pathway to release epinephrine and norepinephrine from the adrenal gland. T1, L2, anterior root, spinal nerve, white rami communicante, sympathetic chain, splanchnic nerve to adrenal medulla, synapse, spinal nerve pathway, T1, L2, anterior root spinal nerve, white rami communicante, sympathetic chain, ascend, descend, stay the same, synapse on a paravertebral ganglion, gray rami communicante, ventral or dorsal ramus, the smooth muscle in the body wall, post-ganglionic sympathetic nerve pathway, T1, L2, anterior root, spinal nerve, white rami communicante, sympathetic chain, ascend synapse in a paravertebral ganglion, cardiac nerve or other post-ganglionic sympathetic nerve, to viscera in the thorax or head and neck.
That's it for the four pathways.